I travel to speak my words in freedom before a tyrant, but nonetheless, there is no greater god than Dionysus.
Bro, this stranger is so close. I can feel the fire of the Bacchians on us. There is no time to waste. This is shameful to the gods. Copy. Men, run quickly to the electron gates. Gather everybody. The horse riders, the arrow shooters, the catapult drivers. There is no time to waste. Tell them we must declare war against the Bacchians. We cannot get defeated by mere women. Over.
My words have convinced you of nothing, Pentheus. Even though you've treated me so badly, I ask you to calm down. Romeus will not take kindly unto you sending his women away from the mountains where they worship.
I'm not here to receive your advice. You've escaped the fetters already. Do you want another punishment?
If I were you, I'd do what all folk around here do to the gods, which is offer a sacrifice. Instead of getting angry, it's like kicking at thorns.
Ha! For him, I'll sacrifice a lot of women. That'll teach them disturbing all the valleys of Kithaeron.
You'll all be chased away, and what a shameful sight that would be, to see all these bright bronze shields fled from the thyruses of the Bacchians.
How on earth have I gotten mixed up with this stranger? Whether tied up or loose, he won't shut up.
Pentheus, there's still time. There's still time for you to make things right again.
How? By becoming a slave to my women's slaves?
I'll bring all the women here for you, using no weapons at all.
Oh, sure. What a nice little trap that would be for me, wouldn't it?
What would be the whole point of me setting a trap? What would be the point of me saving you using my cleverness?
You've had all this arranged so that you can convert my city to believing in your god.
Good job, Pentheus. You figured it all out. I've already talked to the gods about it. You're absolutely right.
Guards, bring me my weapons, and you shut up!
Hold on, Pentheus. Do you really want to go see the woman on that mountain, all of them together like that?
Sure, of course. I'd pay a whole lot of gold to see that sight.
Why are you so eager?
I want to see these poor, wretched women drunk.
Won't that be hard for you to watch? Like, what possible pleasure could you get from seeing that?
Absolute pleasure. I'll be quietly hiding behind the fir trees.
Even though you'll be hiding, they'll still know you're there.
I guess I'll go quite openly then.
Alright, then let's go. Do you really want to do
it? Get me there quickly. I'd hate to lose any more time because of you.
Okay, let's go. But first, Pentheus, we'll need to change your clothes. You need to wear fine linen.
Whoa. You want to dress me up as a woman?
Yeah, because if you show up there as a man, they'll kill you.
I guess. I can see you're an old hand at this sort of trickery.
Dionysus taught me everything I know.
So how do we do all this?
Let's go back into the palace and I'll dress you up.
Okay. You want to dress me up with what? Women's clothes?
Don't you want to go see the magians?
Well, yeah, but tell me the rest.
Okay, well, first I'll start off by letting your hair fall all over your back.
All right, then?
And then I'll dress you in long robes, all the way down to your feet. And in your hair, we'll put a ribbon.
And after this?
Well, you can hold a thyrus in one hand and a dappled spawn skin all over your body.
No. Look, I just can't dress in women's clothes.
Fine. But if the Bacchians capture you, it'll be your blood on the ground, not mine.
Yes, right then. When we get there, we first must spy on them.
Yeah, that's why we're going there, for you to spy on them. It's far wiser to hunt the dangers without putting yourself in danger.
How will we get through the city without being seen or being seen by the Cadmeans?
Oh, we'll take the deserted roads. Don't worry about that. I'll guide you.
We must do what's necessary so that the Bacchians don't see this coming. I'm going inside to think about it all.
Sure. Go ahead. I'm ready to help you with anything you need.
I'm going, and I either take up my weapons or take your advice.
Women, we have trapped our man. He will go to the Bacchans, and with his death, justice will be achieved. Dionysus, it is up to you now to get revenge. You are not very far. First of all, take away his mind. Give him a slight dose of madness, enough for him to wear women's clothes. Otherwise, if his mind is clear, he won't wear them. Then I've got to make a fool of him, parading him through Thebes, dressed as a woman. That will teach him up to make those dreadful threats of his. I'm off now to dress him up in his funeral clothes, the clothes with which he will be meeting Hades once his mother slaughters him with her bare hands. Only then will he learn that the son of Zeus, Dionysus, is a god of peace for the good folk, that he is also the fearsome god to those who don't respect him. Holy Zeus!
Into a great bull and have two huge horns sprout out of your head. Were you a beast before?
Good, Pentheus, your eyesight has been restored. You can see properly now. You see, God is with us now instead of fighting against us like he was before.
So how do I look, Mom? Do I look more like my mother Agave or Ino?
To tell you the truth, if I look closely, I think you look a little bit like both. Wait, what's that? One of your curls came loose.
I just had a little bit of a dance, and I was moving my head around a bit, and I guess I got knocked out of place.
Here, let me fix it. Lift your head up.
Come, I'm in your hands. Tidy me up just a little bit.
Well, your girdle is really loose, and
yeah.
The doesn't go down all the way.
Yeah, I thought so, but is it good on the left leg, though, right?
You'll see, Pentheus. I'm going to become your best friend once you see how wise and well-behaved the Bacchians are.
So how do I hold the thyrus, in my left hand or my right?
Hold it in your right hand, and lead with your right leg too. I'm glad you've changed your mind about all this.
Do you think I'll be able to lift the whole mountain, its valleys, and all the Bacchiates on my back?
Oh yeah, you'll be able to do anything you want, now that your mind has been restored, because you couldn't do it before.
Well, should I use great levers and pulleys, or use my bare hands to do it?
You just have to make sure you don't ruin the Bacchian's haunts or the dens of Pan, because you know how much Pan loves to play his pipes around there.
Quite right, quite right. I won't use my strength to defeat just mere women. I'll hide among the fir trees.
Oh yeah, absolutely. You should still hide, because you're going to be spying on them.
Ha! I think I'll be catching these women as I catch little birds inside their love nests.
That's the whole point you're going, to spy on them and catch them. That is, if they don't catch you first.
Take me right through Thebes. I want everyone to know that I can do this and that they can not.
You are the bravest of us all, Pentheus. No man can go through such trials as you can. Follow me. I'll be your guide and savior. I'll lead you there. And then once we've gotten there, others will take my place.
My mother, yes?
You're a reverend symbol to us all, Pentheus.
That's why I'm coming.
Take you from me and to deliver you to...
Take me from you like a spoiled child, you mean?
Your mother.
You're giving me such a big head with your compliments.
And what a big head it is.
I do deserve it, of course.
You're a mighty man, Pentheus. Mightier than the mighty. And there are mighty battles waiting for you. Mighty enough for your glory to reach the heavens. Oh, Agave and all your daughters of Cadmos, open your arms, get ready for the man I'm bringing you, receive him, and offer him this mighty battle, a battle of which I'll be the winner, I and Dionysus.
Wait, are we done?
Yeah.
When shall I dance once more with bare feet the all-night dances, tossing my head for joy in the damp air in the dew? As a running fawn would frisk for the green joy of the wide fields, freed from fear of the hunt, freed from the circling beaters and the nets of the woven mesh, and the hunters hallowing on their yelping packs. Then hard pressed, she sprints with the quickness of the wind, bounding over the marsh, leaping for joy by the river, joyous at the green of the leaves, where no man is. What is wisdom? What gift of the gold? What gift of the damn? What is wisdom? What gift of the gods is held in honor like this to hold your hand victorious over the heads of those you hate? Honor is cherished forever.
Slow but unsteady, the might of the gods move. It punishes that man that honors folly. And with mad conceit, disregard the gods are crafty. They lie in ambush, a long step of time to hunt the unholy. Beyond the old belief, no thought, no act shall go. Small, small is the cost. To believe in this, whatever is God is strong, whatever long time has sanctioned, and the law of nature, what is wisdom? What gift of the gods is held in honor like this, to hold your hand victorious over the heads of those who hate? Honor is cherished forever.
Blessed is he who escapes a storm at sea, who comes home to his harbor. Blessed is he who emerges from under affiliation. In various ways, one man outtraces another in. Race for wealth and power. 10,000 men possess 10,000 hopes. A few bear fruit in happiness, the others go away. But he who garners day by day a happy life, him I can call truly blessed.